What we want to do today is learn how to work with the blend tool, which is a tool that creates a transition from one shape to another using a specific number of steps. Let's take an example. Of course, this is one of the things we can do with the blend tool. This is another thing we can do with it. Let's take a simple example first. We have this rectangle, which I will give a color, say red. Alt move to create another one, but this one is gonna be like this and like that, say, and I'm gonna give it the color, say, a turquoise color, like this one. I want to create a transition between the two. The transition is going to be done with the blend tool. So, the blend tool is found down here. Alright, that's the blend tool. I will click on it, and what I'm expected to do is select the start and the end. That's what I'm expected to do. So I clicked on the start, and then I click on the end, and automatically I have a transition from one shape to another. All right. Now, I will go to layers, and here I need to look at my blend. You see, that's the blend that I'm working with now. If I expand it, I see that I have three components. I have the path, and then I have the two other rectangles. So let's say I want to move the red rectangle. I will click here, so that this is my selection now, and therefore, whatever I move will be this. If I choose the other rectangle from down here, that's the one I would be moving. If I click on the path, I'll be moving the path, which is moving the whole blend. But if I go to my direct selection tool, and I am in the path, I can grab one of the points and move it. Now, as an extra, I can go to my pen tool, and I can click to add a point. Remember, I'm still in the path level here. So if I grab the point and moved it, all right, here I'm gonna lock the other two so that I don't select them by mistake. If I grab the point and moved it, that's what I would get. All right, so I get the blend changing. If I go to my convert anchor point tool and I click and drag, I'd be also curving the blend, which is starting to be similar to what I had here. I can go back to my direct selection tool and move the points around to change the orientation. Now here, I have a specific number of steps. So if I double-clicked on the blend, I can actually change and check preview to see the changes happen. So for example, if I choose smooth color, I will have a smooth transition. If I have a specified steps, let's say 15, I would have 15 steps added. If I have 3, for example, I would have 3 steps added, which is 1, 2, and 3, plus the original 2 that I had. Now look here, how all of them have the same upright orientation. If I change the orientation, they will rotate with the path. So if I press OK and I change the orientation of the path with the direct selection tool, they will also change orientation. So if I grab this point here and place it there, and grab that one and place it here, all right? And then grabbed this point here and adjusted the orientation, I would see how the points take the orientation of the path. If I wanted to increase the number of points or the number of elements inside, I would double click on my blend tool, and here I can increase and see the difference. While all these have the same orientation, these take the orientation of the line. So this is specific steps, specified steps. Specified distance is the distance between every two steps. So if I set it, say, to 1 centimeter, all right, I would have 1 centimeter between every two steps. If I set it to 5 centimeters, I would have fewer steps because of the larger distance. If I set it to 0.1 centimeters, I would have a very smooth path because the distance is now low. And if I choose smooth color, it would be the smoothest. All right, so that's the blend tool, how you can have a blend between two shapes, how you can edit the line, and you have to use the layers palette to control this. Now, as an exercise, we want to create this logo for the Star Wars movie.